It's a tough
one. Going into the losers final now.
Sky Nihilic is so interesting.
It is really, really interesting. I think Nihilic surprised a lot of people. Like, if you're not really aware of who he was probably kind of surprising that he was able to defeat Madly Tungsten and was also able to 4-1 Just. Because these are two, like, Madly Tungsten and Just are ridiculously good players.
Yeah.
And Nihilic really showed that he definitely does belong to the top here. And this is going to be really, really interesting because now, as opposed to the match that we just had, the skill sets of the players are completely different because Guy is, like, can manage speed, definitely, but it's going to get difficult because I think Nihilic is better at accuracy than Sky's at speed, like, comparatively. So I'm very curious to see how this goes.
Yeah, and also Sky and Nihilic are the only two people who managed to get maps of Khaki so far. The only two. Just didn't manage it. Alex also didn't manage it. Khaki's been on an absolute tear. You gotta say it. Only three people left in the tournament. Sky and Nihilic are both top three right now. They just have to fight over the chance to go back up there and face Khaki in the grand final.
And whoever wins has to face Khaki twice. Which is not gonna, like...
It's
gonna be really difficult.
Definitely.
But you know, we did have bracket resets before. I was very, very happy to see that in the CZ Winter Cup. Might happen again, who knows? By the way, the images of the playlist is amazing. Like, the tactical magician is just, it's so brilliant. Like, you can't really see your face there because...
No, yeah, it's... I put the letters over it. But still.
But this, it's so brilliant. I love that so much.
I think I made those, like, in 5 minutes. But yeah.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. It's still super fun. Alright, so players are going to... Okay, pick some bands now.
It's a bit bigger there on Nihilic's screen.
Yeah, it's high quality. You can still, as I said, you can't really see like the face section because it's just written pool over it. But still, it's so good. I just enjoy that so much.
Wonderful. Okay. I think they're doing pick spans currently. Yeah, that's what they're doing. Oh, maybe we can chime in a little bit and see. Just have a listen.
We can listen. So, Sky is high seed this time around. So first ban is going to start by Nihilic, and Sky has the first pick. I honestly feel like it might be... Like, what we are going to see now might be, like, a complete switch around through, like, last round. You know, Sky going for the slow maps while Nihilic picks the maps that Sky picked earlier.
Yeah, I think that's... You pretty much spelled exactly what I think is going to happen. That sounds absolutely reasonable. Because you can't... We've seen it. If Madly can't beat Nihilic on speed, like... What do we do?
It's just like, there's not many people left who could.
Yeah, exactly. We're kind of running out of talent here.
Yeah, I mean, there's still Radiac in the German leaderboard, who I don't think signed up for this tourney at all, unless I forgot about it.
Not here.
So Radiac might be able to do it, but he said, if you're not here, you can't beat people, right?
That's true. That's very true.
That is, like, you know, the wisdom I'm going to share with everyone. Can't win if you're not there.
We are just waiting for them to do their picks and bans, which obviously takes a long time because, again, everyone has three bans and we have, like, 13 maps. It's a giant map pool.
It is... I honestly enjoy large map pools like these. This is like leaves way more room for like tactics while doing picks and bans. If you just have like one ban each, which happens with a lot of map pools. The issue is after you've banned, if you go to a tiebreaker, every map just has to get played after. And there is like no more tactics down the picking line except for like the actual order. So having more than two bans makes it like way more interesting.
Yeah, especially if you stagger the bans like we are doing here.
Yeah, because you can also like see what your opponent is going for and then act accordingly. If you see like your opponent going for tech instead of speed, even though you expected speed, you could just be like, okay, you know what? I'm just gonna ban the other tech map. Maybe my opponent has a plan that I'm not understanding here.
Mm-hmm.
That is something I really, really like.
It is only a matter of days.
Maybe half a day if we're lucky.
I think they're done though.
Yeah, they're done.
Nice.
Give us the pizza bands.
Give us the pizza bands now.
There they are.
Oh, thank God they also banned. They also banned the weird Japanese/Asian/Chinese character. I don't know what language that is. I'm very sorry, map. That is, it's banned by Nihilic.
Which is hilarious because last time Sky banned that.
I mean, maybe he would have banned it. Nihilic was first banned on this, so we don't quite know if Sky would have banned that himself. Sky then banning Speed of Link, which is absolutely reasonable.
Yes, I agree.
Because, again, Nihilic on speed.
Pure, yeah.
Scary. Then going into the picks, Sky starting out with Fly Again. Pretty much a very slow map. Yes. Then the two picks by Nihilic are 300 knots per minute and Roxanne. So he's not entirely going max speed. He's going also into the tech map.
I mean, he did see Sky just play that map, right? So he might just have the knowledge that he can do better on it.
Check that. And Nihilic has also a pretty disgusting score there.
I mean, Nihilic is a combo machine. We saw that. On a map like that, being able to combo is just so oddly. It's so good to be able to combo.
And then the last map of that set, picked by Sky, is New Amsterdam. The slow one we've seen before.
Yes, so Sky going full on egg, picking the two slowest maps. And Nihilic going for speed and tech. So this is going to be really, really interesting. This one is... I don't think we saw that map last time.
Which one?
Fly Again. No, we didn't see this one yet. This is the slowest map. Only 3.3 notes per second. So that is like right in the middle of standard egg. Quite slow for like a tournament like this. 3 minutes long and it is quite eggable.
Oh, it was the very last ban from Kaki last time, so we did not quite get to that.
So this map is also very close to be 99-able. I think Rock has a 98.9 or something on this.
I'm checking. Oh, you can't see accuracy. Rock has the world record, though.
Yes. Let me check, because I have secret sauce. Rocker has a 98.96 on this.
Alright.
So, we're not going to see a 99 here. I'm going to predict that. You know, just make predictions that aren't going to come through anyways. You know?
crazy prediction, honestly. They're not going to 100% it.
Yeah, that's true. You know, because they already hit 114. Yeah, but so far we can see Sky being at that 98.65, which is really, really good. Nihilic at that 98, which is also pretty good. But currently Sky just showing that he's really good at egg. The most difficult part of this map are the diagonals, which is kind of funny.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's not difficult at all.
Yeah, you always have to see it in context of what the map is actually trying to do.
Yeah, know, having like a few doubles and stuff, it's like not super, super crazy. Sky not quite happy with his performance, but it doesn't really matter. He's half a percentage ahead.
Yeah.
As long as he doesn't miss, he got it in the bag.
Not even the 98 flat. Just not quite consistent enough on the super Aki swings.
Yeah, but you can see it too. Like look at Sky's swings. They're slow, controlled, you know. He's hitting the blocks in the middle of the sabers. And Nihilic is using speed swings. Just playing speed swings on accuracy. If Nihilic practiced accuracy a bit more and like his swings naturally kind of degrade towards like X swings, I think he would do a lot better on this. But that requires practice. It's like not something that you just do. Some players do it, but they're weird. I'm not gonna like. Like I think Small Fox is one of these players. He plays like two egg maps and then suddenly he's like ridiculously good at it.
But, yeah, and I think you can see that in his swings. If you look at Sky Screen, you see him carefully lining up every single node. The swings are very very much in line with the nodes. They're very, very straight as well. And on Nihilic, you can see if you gave him five different downswings, he would approach all of them with a very different angle.
Yes.
He's also curving his sabers inward and outward a lot. More inward as it looks right now. Currently could also be his FOV though.
Yeah, it is difficult to tell because the Z offset of the camera is too much like in front of his face, basically.
But I think you can definitely see the angle.
Yeah, but he is like ridiculously consistent, right? I don't think that 98.0 changed once in the entire map.
I haven't seen a change in that either.
I think he hit like three nodes and since then it was like 98%. Oh, 98.08 actually.
Almost the 98.1.
We didn't see that. I think it's very... We can comfortably say that we are not going to see a replay here.
Yeah, I tend to agree. Pretty good start from Sky. 2K on this map. Replay. Not expecting one.
Yeah, like a replay would be really weird on this. There's just like... There is no reason to. Like even for memes, it would be weird.
Yeah, Ned, I don't know if you want to go for memes this late.
Yeah,
in the
tournament. not in the losers' final.
Yeah.
But that being said, I'm not sure. Was it even said that the winner of Nihilic versus Just were basically playing for third place? So like third place is already like these players have guaranteed their third place spot already.
Yep.
I don't think if we mentioned that. So this is basically, you know, going for at least second place, which is also kind of important. You definitely want to be second. You know, the prize pool, we never talked about the prize pool. You know, the prize pool actually, it's kind of insane. Currently, the prize pool is sitting at, oh dear Lord, what is it sitting at? I'm not seeing it. Let me quickly look. It's sitting at 650 euros, which is a lot. And first place gets 50%, second place gets 30%, and third 20%. So third place already is getting, like, how much are we looking at? It's like
120 bucks, yeah.
Yeah, it's like for third place. That's like first place for some tourneys.
And that's confirmed for both of these players. They are at least getting 120 euros for this.
Yeah. That is quite insane.
That's a big, yeah, and it's also, but you're getting 180 if you win this match, so... So it's definitely a big incentive for both of them to keep playing to the very best of their performance here. 20 seconds into the second map. This one is picked by Nihilic again. You can already see it's a lot faster. We are playing, because I already forgot. Ah, let me find it. We are playing. This is the wrong screenshot. This one. Where is it? We're playing 300 nuts per minute.
What do you guys think? And Nihilic is currently holding 97% on this. Is actually quite close between both players right now. This guy's doing really, really well on this, but I know I'm kind of repeating myself, but like the ending slider screen last time we saw Sky miss on that. That is going to be again like the decider if things stay that time. Because like this is a place where a singular miss could make the difference, but if you just miss an entire slider at that end, it's gonna kill you.
That might
what
be
is
the
that
end.
Offset, Nihilic? What the hell is that?
That
oh
is
my
close.
God!
the pure reaction time needed is insane.
Like, are the blocks actually spawning inside him? Like, what is this?
It's very, very close.
I think like the camera settings are making it worse because the camera is like,
yeah, it's nosy offset, like... I think.
But still, that is so insane.
Sky with a much more conservative node spawn location. It looks a lot slower on the screen.
I enjoy Sky's offset way more. It's like it makes me so nervous.
It makes the map readable for me. I'm too old for that left one.
Oh my god, that is insane. Oh no, Sky!
I know! Hit the bomb! Oh no!
And he was already behind!
Why would you do that? Oh my god.
Oh, he just like, missed
first
that.
He absorbs the wall, now the bombs.
Sky is getting defeated by the environment here. The nodes isn't even the hard part. He needs to battle the walls and bombs as well.
Yeah, maybe the jump and run part of Beat Saber 2.
Sky almost. Oh yeah, losing timing here as well. He did the same thing on the last part as well. This is the ending, what you talked about last time. This can be very difficult for Sky, and he does it again. That was tracking. That was tracking. Tracking for Sky, 14 misses. Dude, I find it so hard to judge how well Nihilic is timing his swings, because you can't see anything. It's so close.
Yeah, that tracking moment was probably caused by CV1. That happens sometimes.
Yeah, especially on super fast bursts. But like, Nihilic has a 96. This guy's not going to beat that.
No. Like, even I mean, with a full combo, might have been close. I'm just thinking, I think right hand was holding 110.8 average cut and left like 110.3 or something. So he might be just below that 96. It would have been close. But again, I'm not expecting any replay shenanigans on this.
No, I don't think so either. Don't think. Yeah, there's not going to be a replay. Nihilic is taking his first point. 1-1 in this series. Best of 7 again. So we have a long road ahead of us.
Lots of maps.
Means we can get into the next. I have closed the thingy.
Close the thingy. Next map is Roxanne. Like, look at the jump distances. Nihilic is at 15.4 and Sky is at 20.4. Like, the difference is 5. It's like one quarter lower. Like, he's playing at 3/4 of the jump distance that Sky has.
Yeah, and then you got to remember that his node is like 2 meters in front of his camera is like 2 meters in front of his face. It looks so close. It's crazy. And again, because we haven't talked about it last time, just before this map starts, if you want to contribute to the prize pool, it's still open. Someone mods put a link to the prize pool in chat. Donate all your money, so Nihilic, Sky, and Kaki can get it. Yeah, all of your money. All for the gram. We are gonna bankrupt the German population by giving money to Beat Saber players. Would be very much appreciated. The players are fighting the best they can to win these prizes. I love this map. It's crazy. This might make me boot up Beat Saber again, like, tomorrow to play it.
It just blows my mind that Nihilic is able to read, like, a tech map on 15.5 jump distance.
I think it looks even worse on this map than the last one.
It does.
Okay, look how different... If you're watching, look how different this looks. They are playing the exact same map, and it... Look how faster it is for Nihilic.
I'm just like
Sky.
Imagining, like, you know, this could be like a perfect mean. Oh, there's a duck wall. No one hit it. I'm just imagining, like, you know, like elevator music on the right for Sky and on the left just like someone screaming his heart out.
Yeah, that was Sky needs to remember that there's a real duck wall later. That's pretty sneaky from the map.
But I think he remembers because he hit it last time.
I think so too.
What are we looking at in accuracy? 96.2 for Nylik. He's ahead. Ahead by 0.2 is a big thing on a tech map.
But then again, you know, like, missing is not out of the question on maps like this. Like, the most difficult part, I think, is just ahead, which is, like, very hard to read. I'm not really sure if that is, like, readable on his top distance.
The diagonals. Actually, very weird angles, and you see Nylik is dropping a little bit in accuracy. Meanwhile, Sky is up. They're about equal right now.
They are quite equal now, yeah.
No, Sky, watch out for the next ball. I don't quite know when exactly it is, but I think there's one more coming. Oh, Nylik missed! I didn't see that. What happened to him? Wait, I can see on the mainstream actually.
I think there was a bad cut from an early swing or something. Like
it
that.
Was it was a double. It was one blue swing on the left and then go right into a double, and he missed that. He missed the double. Maybe there was a bit because it was too hard to read because it was so fast. You don't really expect an out of the blue right cut on the left side.
I mean, that's what tech does, right? It does things you don't expect. It's kind of the point.
And the fact that Sky is looks like he's about twice the time to read any pattern.
I mean, Sky is shaking his head, but that was a really solid performance.
Yeah, 96.
Like accuracy wise, they're like very, very close. So we might actually see a replay here, like with the full combo. Nylik would have taken this one, but generally Sky did really, really well.
96.08. Sky beat Nylik's PB by 1K. I don't know why he doesn't have a score on it. Maybe it's just not submitting scores.
Maybe uninstalled score saver or something.
Yeah, but Nylik's PB was about 1K below what Sky just scored.
Is that PB with a miss?
It probably isn't. I don't know.
I can check quickly. Where am I Nylik at there? No, that's a full combo, actually. So his current score, actually, like with a full combo, would have been better than that.
All right, the players are taking a tiny bit of a break before we're getting into the next maps. Nylik will not call a replay, as it seems. Means Sky will take the second point. Which is big, because this was Nylik's pick.
That is really big for Sky. So we might, you know, if he does it, we might get actually like the rematch between him and Kage. But how funny would it be if Sky manages to win this and then manages to win against Kage? We'd have Kage versus Sky three times. That'd be funny as hell.
And it's the same map pool. I don't know.
It is the same map pool.
That's difficult. That's very difficult. Because we've seen Kage can beat Sky on this map pool. We'll have
but to for see. Now, Sky still has a wall in front of him, you know. Beating Nylik is definitely not a small feat.
So. Yeah, no, we shouldn't really look ahead of that.
I was just like thinking in if.
That is true.
Would have been really funny. Or could be, you know, still possible. But in the meantime, we can look ahead and pick some bands a little bit. We're currently at the last pick from the first pick phase by Nylik, which means after this one, we would go to New Amsterdam, which is the second slowest accuracy map. We saw that one before. Probably is going to go in favor of Sky as well. If Fly again is, you know, giving us any information, it's just that Sky is pretty darn good on accuracy and is probably going to be able to dish out pretty darn good scores. Oh, Nylik already returned. That was quick. That was quite fast. So I don't think that... Yeah, I was going to say, I don't think that the replay was decided yet and Nylik actually goes for it. I think that's a smart idea. I think that's a smart idea, but the full combo here had this.
Yeah, the difference between... What was it? 3.7. Like, yeah, yes. FC, he can beat Sky.
He can. He just has to FC, and like full comboing is something he can definitely do. He might honestly want to like increase the jump distance a little bit, but no, he doesn't apparently. I just thought like it might be helpful, maybe going for like a 16 or something, but he doesn't care.
He wants to do it again.
I'm also like supremely impressed by self-control. I gotta say that, like, not pressing the trigger is like, how is that even possible? Like,
to not skip the intro, yeah. That's rough. Rough to not do that. Does Nylig not have sound on his stream?
I don't think he does.
I don't need it. We have Sky.
And currently, Nylig is like doing really well on this. Holding a 96.6. That's really, really good.
He was getting so ready for that one. He ducked down like 2 seconds before the dodgeball even came up. He knew it. It makes sense if you have like milliseconds to react. You need to predict as best as you can. He misses again. I think it's the same section.
I think it was the exact same note again.
He missed the exact same way. No. Oh, that is so rough. Okay, now Nylig needs to act out of his mind. Yeah, that was.
I don't think that's gonna happen, honestly.
The miss looked exactly the same.
It looked exactly the same.
It was the same note in the same space. Missed it the same way. Just not prepared for the left swing and then all the way to the double on the right. Poor Nylig.
But honestly, like, that accuracy might actually just hold up. Like, that's kind of insane. I think Sky had a 96.
Well. Yeah, okay, Sky's not out of it. Missed too many. That makes it interesting. I don't quite know what Sky finished with.
I think it was like 96%. Let me quickly check.
Don't have the numbers for that.
I can kind of find out. Yeah, it was basically a 96.05. So it is possible if Nylig just dishes out more 115s here. It's so difficult though. Oh no, I think the map is too far gone now.
Yeah, no, he doesn't. Because to the end, he PB'd by about 500 points. 500 points above his previous score. That was not his PB. Doesn't quite beat Skygen. He had the chance. That's so unfortunate, but picking up the,
really unfortunate, yeah.
The cookie cutter, perfect, exact same miss two times in a row. That's rough. And that loses Nylig the replay and the map. Second point for Sky. And now we're getting back into Sky's pick.
This was a very, very important win for Sky.
Yeah, 100%.
Because like now you got rid of the replay by your opponent and you won that pick. That's
on their map. That's massive.
All right, next map is going to be New Amsterdam by Fox Stevenson. That is a very, very jammer of a map and a very, very slow map. So, you know, I think the advantage is on Sky side on this again. But then again, you know, all things might happen. It really kind of depends, because I think Sky does act this one quite a bit worse in comparison to Fly Again. You know, Fly Again, he did amazingly at like 98.5 or 6 or something like that, absolutely. Which is quite insane. I don't think he's able to act this quite as well. I'm hesitant to say that Nylig is able to get like a 98.2 on this. It's probably going to end up at a 98 again. So I do think that Sky has an advantage, but honestly, you know, I don't think anything is decided. The most important thing is actually reducing the jump distance further for Nylig. Can't go like above a like above the extra time of 5 minutes.
They're a bit closer now, at least 15, and Sky's at 18. But still,
yeah.
I don't think is Nylig ever gonna go higher than 15. We will never know.
All right. Dream sync, syncing the streams again, and then map starting again while the pressed trigger to skip is triggering me.
I mean, he has to enact the self-control. If he hits that, technically it means an immediate map loss.
Yes, so don't.
I wouldn't, yeah, don't play around with that. Just be careful, Nelly. That would be a rather sad way to go. But it's his risk. Players know they are not allowed to do that. If they keep the mod installed, it's their risk.
And this one is already way, way closer than the last map that we had. Nihilic again, kind of gravitating towards that 98. A little bit lower, but Sky actually, you know, only 0.2% ahead. Mm. Which is not that much, all things considered. Yeah, play.
98 was also exactly the same accuracy as in the first map.
Yes.
We've seen the two play. Might be that just in terms of true egg, Nihilic is not able to go much above that. You know, Sky's cap is a little bit higher.
Yeah, but Sky is losing on the stacks, is losing on the doubles here.
Nihilic is too.
Yeah, but not as much. Oh no, he's actually. What? What was that? That was like a crazy underswing.
Yeah, I think the diagonals as well were a bit difficult for him.
Not really sure what happened on Nihilic's side there on that one hit. That dropped the score by 0.1% as well. Just like one block.
This guy very consistent. He's almost on a 13 points on each end.
Yeah, very, very close. Still holding above that 98%. Nihilic did drop off quite a bit. And this does look like Sky is gonna take this somewhat comfortably.
Currently does look
still like, oh. A few doubles and stacks to go. So a few more score drops probably incoming. Both players holding consistent egg throughout that though. No troubles with that whatsoever. And we have around 30 seconds to go here. So I don't think these scores are gonna change too much here.
Yeah, I agree. This guy's not gonna pick up a miss here. This map is too easy. He's confident with this. He's been playing for so long, he has his mental game up. Up to the task. Taking it all the way to the end. 98 for Sky. Also, yes. Something I just noticed, Nihilic is playing with the wonderful Beat Saber Germany Winter Tournament Sabers. I made specifically for this tournament. Very look very, very beautiful.
They are amazing, indeed.
That's why you sign up for our tournaments, okay, people? Because you get cool stuff.
You get cool stuff. Like, really cool stuff. Made with, I think, like, the profile pictures of the players are actually ingrained into the Sabers, which is pretty cool.
That's pretty cool.
That is really cool.
Your own thingy.
You know, okay. You could have probably even put your own face on it if you wanted to. Or like a magician's face. That would also work.
Yeah, put my face on it. I love that. Just give him, just save us with my face on him.
I love that.
Okay.
Too.
If we don't get a replay on this.
We can't get a replay. Nihilic doesn't have one.
Oh, he doesn't have one. Third point for Sky. That means, let's talk a bit more about the pick ban phase. The second set of bans. We're starting with Sky, who banned Girl in the Mosh. It's one of the faster maps, I believe.
Yes.
And Nihilic went for Shiny Happy Days.
That is interesting.
Why is that interesting?
Because that is also a tech map. He picked one tech map and banned the other one.
Well, he lost on the first one.
Yeah, but he didn't know that before. He was gonna lose.
That's true. I mean, maybe he had a brainwave that he was supposed to ban the second one. Maybe that was a good idea. Getting into the last set of picks the players were able to make themselves. The next ones we're going to be seeing, we're starting with Nihilic's pick, which is Bring Me the Horizon. Yes. I don't know if that's the actual name of the name that of the is,
that
group.
That is the band. Obey.
Okay, Obey is the name of the map. By Muffin, my beloved, and Bean. Sky's pick is going to be Love Story, Taylor Swift, the first one we've seen in the previous match. Very slow one indeed.
So this map is not too crazy fast, actually, you know. I would actually call this just like plain mid speed. It is very, very accurate. You know, a lot of players are getting very close to 98 on this. It does have these it's kinda like if you bring me the Horizon and Muffin together, you end up with these one-handed parts on either hand going with the it just goes along with the beat. You always have that. You know, those parts are fast, but they're just like 3 to 4 blocks, so generally doable even if you're not comfortable with the speed.
Sky, stop shaking your head! He's doing it so much!
I mean, he is currently behind. Maybe he can just smell it, because maybe he knows that he
not
needs a 97.
Not behind by much.
Not much, but a little bit. This is an absolute banger, though. I love the song.
Miss 95.9 is what Sky drops to.
It's unfortunate. Got 2 more minutes to go, so a lot of things can happen, but Nylink's looking very comfortable on this. Guy working himself back up to that 96%, but score difference is still quite huge. Just egg-wise, this is not going to be enough, so... Basically, Nylink just has full control of this now. If he doesn't miss, he wins this.
Yep. And he needs to. This is Guy's match point, and Nylink does not have a replay. We need to see a clean series from Nylink now. Cannot afford to lose any more maps.
Is Sky still shaking his head or is he jamming? Yeah. I'm not sure. Like,
maybe he knows that he doesn't really have the ability to get back up to Nylink's accuracy. And then is taking the map a bit less seriously. Which of course is not a good thing to do because you don't know if your opponent secretly missed like 5 nodes.
You don't know, yeah. You gotta always assume that your opponent just stopped playing, like for a while, and just go for it.
Nylink is keeping that 96.7 alive so easily and so consistently. His accuracy is crazy.
It is so consistent. He's like holding that 96.7 for like 1,000 notes now again. Like the consistency is just insane. Not a lot of map to go here, only 40 seconds left. This guy is still acting up a little bit. Getting close at 96.3. Meanwhile, Nylink actually did increase his accuracy a little bit. Back to the 96.8 that he was holding right at the beginning. And he missed! But he's still ahead! He's still holding that 96.6! How did he only drop 0.2%? What the hell?
I mean, it is a pretty long map.
It is,
1500 nodes, but still. He dropped very little from that miss.
That was really surprising. Oh, it's a 96.49. Okay, it was just a rounding issue.
Still.
I was going to say, because that was like, that didn't seem right. Score difference of 2,900 points.
This guy doesn't need a replay here. He really doesn't.
I would also not take it.
He has 2 more maps, one of them being his pick. So I don't think it would make sense. Going into the next one, I think he has much, much better chances, and I think I would cover. For example, if you get another tracking loss, just any unfortunate miss, honestly, so you can use the replay on that. That's, I think, the strategy that Sky should do right now.
I agree, you know. This is not his pick, so, going for the replay on your own pick is probably just advantageous.
And that's exactly what he's doing, no replay. Second point for Nylink. He now has the chance to take us to the illustrious tiebreaker. if Nihilic wins this second one, which is an incredible challenge because it is an accuracy map and it's picked by Skygen, so he is confident that he can take this.
This is going to be great because I think like this is already at a speed where the difference is not going to be as big anymore. It is quite linear, but it's almost 6 notes per second. You know, 5.8 notes per second makes this map more like lower mid speed. So it's not quite egg anymore. And considering how consistent Nihilic is and how comfortable he is with higher speeds, he might just actually be able to get very similar accuracies to Skygen here. This is going to be great. I really want to see if Nihilic is able to like 97.5 or 6 this, because I think that is pretty much what Sky got in his match against Kaki.
I think so, yeah.
There we go. Map starting. Nihilic just starting out with 98% again. This is just going to become a meme. I think it's going to go down. Yeah. Okay, it is already gone, but it's going to go down further like when the map actually kind of starts.
For now, he's back. Back on the 98.
Yeah, he's actually like, this is already like way close.
I think that was the first time we saw 98.1 from Nihilic.
Oh my god. He's getting better.
Incredible speed rate, actually. You just let him improve by like 0.1% every day.
And that would be quite insane. I mean,
yeah. Sky on the 98.2. Yeah, we're still in the beginner easy section.
Yes. I mean, it doesn't get much more difficult except for these windows there. But it does get a little bit more.
I mean, there were some bombs, the arch enemy of Skygen, as we've seen before.
Bombs and walls.
Yeah.
These doubles, these are Skygen's big enemy.
I agree.
And this is quite close, you know, 0.2% difference. This is not that much.
No, yeah. Nihilic very close, still 97.6, especially because Sky seems to be dropping.
Yeah, surprisingly at this part. I wonder if it's like the stacks on the outer lane. Again, windows. Players staying more or less consistent on the accuracy, but Sky is still dropping, it's down to that 97.68 again.
Which Nihilic is holding!
Yes! That is going to get really, really close. We're halfway through now. Nihilic did.
Oh, 97.5! But Sky is also going down, I think currently much faster than Nihilic is. Nihilic has his back against the wall, he has 2 minutes left to clutch this map.
And Sky also going down to that 97.5.
He's just at the bottom of the two. I don't know where exactly Nihilic is, if he's dropped further, if he's just at the low end of the cutoff as well.
Still have 1 minute to go. Now the slow part is gonna play in the hands of Sky a little bit.
I agree, yeah.
But he's actually not climbing.
Come on, Nihilic. Yeah, Sky is keeping that. I don't quite know.
It might just be mental fatigue at this point, honestly.
Nihilic is not hitting these too well. He needs more consistent 111s and 12s.
He's always hitting that one.
He's doing them pretty well. Sky did climb out of that as well, though. Pretty decent lead for an accuracy map not being picked up again.
Things are looking a little bit better for Sky now, but
half a minute in it for Nihilic needs a miracle right now.
This is still really, really close because we have no idea where Nihilic
actually. Yeah, it could be up to 0.1 behind Sky, or it could be just at the cutoff. All the way at the end, the last slider. Ooh, Sky! Okay, it's not going to be enough.
Yeah, I think Sky is actually hit by quite a bit. If I saw almost 2k points. Not as close as it looked, because like the percentages
for he wasn't a 4-7. Okay, again, another rounding error.